Welcome to part 2 of my Notion Beginner to Advanced tutorial series. The timestamps for each topic is in the video description, so feel free to skip to any part of the video. The more you begin to use Notion, the more tasks, databases and pages you'll have to navigate between. Links help make connections between related pages. Every link creates a backlink automatically and they are dynamic, meaning they update themselves. You can quickly add pages using the @ symbol. You can make use of Notion's multi-column layout by grabbing your block and then dragging it next to a block until you see the vertical line, which means it will create a new column. Now to add blocks under a column, simply just drag and drop them. If you want to have a three-column layout, then you need to change your page to full width and then simply just repeat the same steps. You are unable to drag inline databases into a multi-column layout, but there is a way to work around this. Use empty blocks and position them as you want, and then simply just drag and drop the inline database inside the empty blocks. When you copy and paste multi-column content, it will retain the layout when you paste them. You can even paste multi-columns into a toggle, add a toggle underneath a column, and then turn the toggle into text, and now you have multi-columns inside a multi-column layout. To create a new database, select one from the empty page or use the /  to select the inline database. Note that if you select a full page database from the empty page, then that's the only content you can have in that page. However, any full page database can be turned into an inline database, allowing you to have multiple databases in the same page. Each data entry you add is its own Notion page where you can add content and even more databases, allowing you to have multiple layers of information in one page. A few useful features you can use is to calculate a column at the bottom of the table. You can wrap cells if the text is longer than the column, and you can also merge your table with a CSV file such as an Excel spreadsheet. Organize your databases with different views. Notion databases are highly customizable, so they can be used for a variety of tasks. Currently, there are 6 different database views, which all have different uses and are pretty easy to understand once you start using them. With each different database view, you can choose which properties you want to show, and it can also be filtered or sorted according to your needs. One of my favorite features is the grouping feature. It allows you to group a database according to any type of property and gives you a lot more customization options. Once you start to play around with different database views, filters, sorting options, and the grouping feature, you'll quickly understand how Notion databases work and be able to create any database tailored to your needs. To share your Notion pages with others, you can toggle the Share to Web option. Everyone with this link will be able to view your Notion page just like any other website. If you toggle Search Engine Indexing, your page will start ranking on Google Search. Anyone with a link can view your Notion page without having a Notion account, but if they want to duplicate the page, comment, or edit on the page, then they will need a Notion account. Any updates made to your Notion page will instantly update on the public page as well. In the description is a link to add the Notion Web Clipper extension to your browser. The Notion Web Clipper allows you to save any website, video, article, or anything else online to either a new database or to an existing database from where you can collect, process, and categorize all your bookmarks. The Notion Web Clipper is also available on your phone, and all you do is share the content to your Notion Web Clipper and it will be added to your Notion database. That's it for my intermediate Notion tutorial. Like the video if you found it useful and subscribe for more Notion content. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.